لا يزال الخير حيا لا يزال، إن في الدنيا سلاما وظلال. أخبر الأيام أن في وصال. قم بنا.
It has become a bad word, and probably it's not the origin of the
Islamic law.
Yeah, I guess so. Same.
I think I know more about the way of Sharia, not about the laws. Mm-hmm. So I would know that.
In the Sharia law, I don't know exactly what it says. I never read about the Sharia law, so I don't know exactly what the law is in Sharia, mm-hmm. other than you have to live and buy the Quran. Yeah. Yeah? Okay.
So I have to say I don't know much about it. What I hear in the media is probably not true. Mm-hmm. In the beginning, it's probably just a way to make society work in a better way. Mm-hmm. I don't know. Sorry.
Well, I think what I know is that that women have to cover their hair. I think that's a part of the Sharia.
Stealing, perhaps, goes under Sharia law. And yeah, I can't remember anything else.
Yeah, I don't really know, but like you have to like live according to the rules in the Quran.
If you've ever heard a politician giving a speech about democracy, you've probably heard him use words like justice, equality, liberty. He may even mention jobs, education. Now, what do you think of when we say Islamic Sharia? You know, in a recent televised event, one of the Muslim presidents actually said, "We're going to bring Sharia, we're going to cut off hands, and we're going to cut off feet." But when you heard the speech about democracy, he didn't promote democracy by mentioning the electric chair, the gas chamber, nor the lethal injection. So why is it that when we market the Sharia, we only mention the prescribed punishments? My name is Kamal Al-Makki, and I'm teaching a single weekend seminar called Confidential, the Tafsir of Surah An-Nur. We're going to look at all 64 verses of the surah, understand all the rulings, look at the different themes from rules of visitation, the accusation against Aisha, and understand what Allah is saying to us.
So,